Hello everybody, SoCal Thero here, welcome back to another episode of American Truck Simulator. Today we're going to be in Salt Lake City, Utah. We are picking up some tires and we're going to be taking them out of state finally. We're going to be going to Elko, Nevada. As you can see, it's a pretty rainy day here and it's probably going to be a night run as well based on the timing. I had to wait a little bit to get something with auto parts to transport. So there's a reason behind the auto parts too. Let me go ahead and get loaded up here so we can get on the road. But if you notice on my trailer, I couldn't get the truck skin to work. I don't know why it doesn't want to work on this vehicle, but it says Callahan Auto. For those of you that are a fan of the movie Tommy Boy with Chris Farley and David Spade, that was the name of his dad's brake company. Well, just auto parts company in general was Callahan. So I wanted to, when I saw this livery, I was like, yeah, I definitely got to do that. I definitely got to do a run in it. So we're doing it in this old Freightliner here. Actually, let me just go ahead and start it up from the outside so you guys can hear it, because it sounds really nice with this Detroit engine in it. Really cool, it looks really good. As you can see, you got the sleeper back there, got all of our stuff here, we got our bag as well. But yeah, it's got a very vintage era feel to it. I shouldn't say vintage, it doesn't feel like that long ago to me anyways, but it probably is. Looks like the green's lighting up here again. We can go ahead and turn our wipers off. Let's go ahead and let the parking brake out. I didn't turn it quite off. There we go. And let's get out on the road. I need to reset my track IR. It seems to not want to be in the right spot. Well, it looks like it is still raining just a bit. It's just sprinkling, so. But yeah, going back to this truck too. So on the description it says it's for 1.35, and I was a little skeptical about it working. So far it seems to be working though, and some of the comments I saw said it doesn't work for 1.36. Others say that it does. From what I could tell, it looks like it does, and from the comments I read regarding the people that said it didn't work, they thought it was maybe a conflicting mod was causing the issue. So I'm glad it's working so far, and I'm in Utah, so it should be working flawlessly throughout the rest of the game. The frame drops I was getting, I'm not sure if that's related to this truck or if it's related to just a different mod in the game right now. Might be just the amount of mods. I might have to take some of these trailer skins out. The mega packs I have, maybe they're causing an issue, I don't know. Show off the interior too much, but I do have some of the I think it's SISA, I believe is his name. I could be wrong. His mods in here too. So you can see I have the transponders in front of me. I got the dash cam over there. I got my Star Wars Imperial logo just hanging off the top here. Then I had a backpack and some sleeping gear and whatnot in case I couldn't sleep in here. Jeez, come on, dude. Are we slowing down again? I don't like tailgating people at all, and speeds like this, it's not helping. We're doing 50 and an 80. This Land Rover's just gonna blow by me. Well, then again, the rain is starting to get a little heavy again. Maybe I can't really fault them too much. This is great. Driving in the dark, in the rain, in a truck I've never driven before, so hopefully this goes over well. And in the type of truck I'm not used to driving too, with the overcab. Lightning and thunder there. Based on the timing, seems like the thunder is, from the thunder, it seems like it's pretty far away. That engine though, man, this thing sounds good. I hope he does upgrade this to the 1.37 with the new sound mods. I'd be interested to hear how this thing sounds. Hey, wait station I actually have to go to. I haven't had to go to one for a while, so not complaining. They gave me my fair share of not having to weigh in, so I'll weigh in now. Coming in pretty hot. Just waiting for this other truck. Come on, dude. There we go. It's close right to here. Weight is 83,843 pounds, so feeling pretty good. I noticed that on some of the 1.37 showcasing that Jeff did, that the scales all have a thing where if your trailer is damaged, they'll fine you for trailer not being in optimal condition, which is pretty cool. That's a great little detail to add to the game. Just makes you want to take care of your trailer even more. Make sure you don't destroy it. This guy is really going to do this to me, isn't he? And this truck's gotta go, and then I'll get in behind this truck. It's dark out here. This truck is just poking up. Oh, now he's getting in the fast lane. And this guy's going slow. Oh my goodness, driving so dangerously here. Why did he even get into the left lane? That makes no sense. He should be staying in the right lane. This pickup truck should be in the left lane if he wants to go around. Yeah, visibility is getting pretty rough out here. It's hard to see out this windshield right now. Let's pick it up another speed here. Let's get him really going. It's dumping right now. Dry drive safely, obey speed limit, don't drink and drive. Sure thing. Welcome to Nevada. Here we go. We're in Nevada. Finally left the state of Utah for a little bit. Drop off, so I think it's just there just to be there. for a vehicle inspection again? Come on, I've been going so good without having to do them, and now I gotta do one. I gotta do two in one episode. That means this guy's gonna pass me. Oh, slow it down. Give me some Jake break there. Yeah. Thank you for your cooperation. Have a safe journey. Thank you. Need it. Oh, what the hell? How am I getting over there? Okay, that's interesting. Let's see how we have to do this. Got a truck in the service department there. Squeeze through here. Looks like this one has a truck pickup as well. Or a truck delivery for new trucks. Oh, it's over there. Okay. Without having to blindside it in, make it. So I'm gonna have to turn completely around. I shouldn't have to blindside it in, but I'm gonna have to get some space here. Oops. Straighten it out. Yeah, I'm in an overcab. I got a lot more space than I think. Back. Oh, no. turn off the engine, but okay. Holy cow. Okay, we're clear. We got plenty of space. Alright, let's get back in. I think I was bumping into that blue thing right there, or this thing right here, this crate, or like trash bin thing up here near the fence was the issue from the last one, but finally got it parked, just took a few tries, so let's go ahead and let him offload the truck. So we drove 205 miles, it took us 5 hours and 24 minutes to do it, we consumed 36.6 gallons of fuel. We earned a total of $11,723, and we also earned 502 in XP. So that's a pretty good little run that we had there with the truck I'm not familiar with. That was a lot of fun to drive, I'm going to be honest. I wouldn't mind driving that again. But anyways, guys, that's going to do it for this episode of American Truck Simulator. Let me know down in the comments below what you thought. If you don't feel like leaving a comment, another way to let me know that you enjoyed the episode is by simply clicking the like button. But until next time, guys, take care. Oh.